My question is Chidimma stateless right now? Because obviously, there's an ongoing investigation about her. There's identity theft which was committed by a mother, blah blah blah. So is she South African? Is she Nigerian? Was she even registered to be a Nigerian citizen? Does she have dual citizenship? So now I don't understand. And it for one to represent the country, you must be that citizen's country, that country's nationality. And the fact that Chidimma grew up in South Africa, does she know any Nigerian culture? She didn't even grow up in Nigeria. So how come she's now gonna represent Miss Chim? How come she's now in the pageant thing? How come she's not a contestant in Nigeria? This is so fishy.
Hello everyone, my name is Chidimma Vanessa Adetshina, and I cannot start off this video without expressing my gratitude to the incredible people who have shown me so much love and so much support. Now, I have received an invitation from the Silverbird Group, who are the organizers of the Miss Universe Nigeria Beauty Pageant. And I say this with great excitement because I have decided to participate in the Miss Universe Nigeria 2024 Beauty Pageant. Now, I understand the expectations and responsibilities that come with this title, and I am so excited to embark on this journey. And I just want to say thank you so much for this opportunity, and I'm looking forward to participating in Africa's most prestigious beauty pageant, Miss Universe Nigeria.
And this was someone who was claiming to be South African a few days ago, a few weeks ago, but now she gladly accepts to become Miss Universe Nigeria. I don't understand. How does this work? Isn't she stateless? Does she even have documents? Because obviously, since the case is ongoing and investigations are going, most probably documents were taken from her. How is she gonna travel to Nigeria? A South African representing Nigeria? I don't understand, guys. Enlighten me. This is so confusing. Hello guys, and welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm your host, Tariro. If it's your first time here, hello and welcome. And if you're a training subscriber, thank you for always tuning in, commenting, and liking my videos. So please make sure you have subscribed to this YouTube channel. Please support me, guys. If you haven't subscribed, kindly click the subscribe button. It's totally for free. And to my returning subscribers, my day ones, thank you for always supporting me, for being there from the beginning of my journey until now. So, guys, without wasting much of your time, in today's video, we'll be continuing with the Chidimma drama. The saga is now getting interesting. So, last week we talked about Chidimma withdrawing from Miss South Africa 2024. And then now, guess what happened? She was invited by the Nigeria Miss Universe to join. And guess what? Your girl Chidimma accepted. So the drama started like when she was contesting for Miss South Africa and she became a finalist. And then her name, Chidimma, and the surname having Nigerian origins, South Africans started questioning her nationality. They were like, "We don't have a Chidimma in South Africa, so where is she from?" Obviously, it's Nigerian. Then they were like, "How come she's South African?" People digged deeper. They started having petitions until it went to the attention of the Home Affairs. Then the minister himself. He did his findings and found out that there was some fraud which was done, identity fraud, identity theft by the mother, and the mother is originally from Mozambique. Then after the scandal, Chidimma had to withdraw from Miss South Africa. So one thing I want you to know, Chidimma actually worked for the good of Miss South Africa. They became more popular, they were trending worldwide. People like me who were not interested in the pageants thing, we started watching Miss South Africa. They started getting views. Views is what matters. So now, South Africans, their issue were like, she doesn't represent us starting from her name. She doesn't speak in South African language. So we cannot be represented by Chidimma, right? And the girl quit because she was fearing for her safety. But now my question is, Miss Nigeria Universe, they have invited her.
As a good citizen of Nigeria, Silverbird Group reached out to her to ask her, would you be so kind to participate in Miss Universe Nigeria since you have Nigeria? I reached out to the national director, Stephanie, who is my personal friend, and she was, her hands were tied because she said it was beyond her, and she could only ask her if she was willing to take part in our national pageant here since it's half Nigerian. Well, we sent a press release reaching out to her. We did not reach her directly. We sent a press release, and then through social media, she got my number and called me, explaining she would have loved to, but we've canceled, we've suspended, we've finished a selection of 24 girls, and that there might be uproar if she moves out of South Africa. So I said, well, think about it. Let us know. You're half Nigerian, half South African. You have every right to participate in any pageants in the country here. So she said she was going to send us a message.
And them inviting her, my question is, does Chidimma represent any Nigerian culture? Considering the fact that she grew up and she was raised in South Africa and she is claiming to be a South African. So how come she's going to represent Nigeria? It doesn't make sense to me. But I also think that Miss Universe Nigeria, they also want to benefit from this girl. Because obviously, they are already trending as well. Miss Nigeria Universe, who watches that? I'm sorry, I'm not being rude, but I'm just saying, most people, it's not that famous you get. But I'm sure after Chidimma joins, they'll become famous. And most people will be interested in watching Miss Nigeria. Even myself, count me in. I even started following them on all their social media platforms. I am a TikTok girl, so I started following their page and to check out, like, what's this Miss Universe Nigeria, seeing the contestants there and seeing if our girl Chidimma will get ads or stand a chance. Then I got interested. So, you see, I think it's gonna work on the interest and on the favor of Miss Universe Nigeria. Also, they're already trending worldwide, and obviously the world is watching and they are recommending and, you know, applauding Miss Universe Nigeria. That's a good gesture that Chidimma was she had issues in South Africa, but now she's going to Nigeria. But my question is on her identity, like, what does it take for one to be Nigerian? Yes, her father is born, like, her father is Nigerian. And obviously, because her father is Nigerian, she qualifies to be a Nigerian. But representing a country, you must be Nigerian at heart. Obviously, she's Nigerian at heart because on her social media platforms, she had the Nigerian flag, yes. But then she didn't grow up in Nigeria. Does she even know Nigerian culture? I don't know. I'm just questioning myself. So at the end, what does it take for one to carry the crown of being Miss Nigeria Universe? What are the ordinary Nigerians thinking about this? Personally, to myself, I'm thinking it's two individuals who wants to benefit. The first one is Chidimma herself. She's someone who wants this Miss Universe badly. Because obviously for you to be Miss South Africa, let's start with Miss South Africa. You must be South African at heart. It's not for you, but it's for the people. You are representing the people. When you go to Miss World or Miss Universe, you'll be carrying the flag of that country. It's no longer about you. You get it. But so now South Africa is out. I'm just saying, if she had won Miss South Africa, was it about her or was it about South Africa? So pageant thing like this, it's not about you, but it's about the country. So personally, I'm not judging her, but I'm just analyzing and thinking that Chidimma is a bit power hungry. And I think that she just wants fame so badly. Because if she was carrying South Africa at heart, right after she withdrew from Miss South Africa, now she gets an opportunity in another country. Now again, she wants to associate herself with that country, and then she wants to represent that country. Is it possible that you carry two countries at heart and you'd want to represent those countries? And obviously, let's say South Africa and Nigeria, when they go at the world level, they'll be fighting each other there, the battle. So now, how can she be fighting against South Africa? The South Africa she claimed to love so much, the South Africa she represented. So to her, it's just about fame. She wants to be famous, according to me. I'm not judging you, but I'm just analyzing. And I think it's for personal gain, not the country at heart. Now, let me also talk about Miss Nigeria Universe. I think it's also for personal gain. The organization itself, they saw that Chidimma is trending. And like I always say, what matters about these online deals is the views, the numbers. So they saw that if they take Chidimma to be on their side, they'll become more famous. Maybe they'll get more donors, more sponsors, and more money. You get? So I don't think it's like they have Chidimma at heart or Nigerians at heart. How can they just take someone who was raised in another country and bring her to represent her in their country? That's fishy. It's for personal reasons. Then last but not least, considering the fact that there's an ongoing case about Chidimma and the mother of the identity theft and stuff, which country does she belong to now? Is she stateless or what? That's my question. Anyways, guys, comment down below. What's your thought on this issue? Feel free to share with me. I always respond. Let's discuss what's happening. I know a lot of you guys were like, leave this issue alone, blah, blah, blah. Guys, I just followed the flow. This Chidimma issue is trending and it's doing good for my channel. Numbers are growing, we are getting the views, and on YouTube what matters is the views. Just the same way this guy is wants Chidimma, that's the same way her issue is also working on my channel. Thank you for the growth. Make sure you subscribe to meet again on next video. Bye for now. Love you guys. Comment.